Hello everyone and welcome back to Let's Play Pizza Tycoon. In the last one we challenged some people to some duels and we managed to win a fair bit of money. I must apologise for the lack of update. I've been suffering from some sort of illness where I couldn't string a sentence together without coughing me guts up. So now that that's all cleared, I'm well enough to record again without offending yous all by coughing a whole lot. So, as you can see, we've got 6,700, which is a healthy amount. I'm not entirely sure it's enough for the end of the month, and it is the 25th of March. So, the end of the month is rapidly approaching. So, you can see we've had a lot of expenditure. A lot of it's come from the furniture, which obviously next month we won't need to buy, and machines we won't need to buy. So actually, if you take them out, then we're actually making a profit, which is good. I mean, we're not making masses of money, but we're making enough, and that's the main thing. Well, we're not really making enough, but hopefully by next month we will be. So see, we've got £9,000 loan out. We've got no insurance because we don't need it yet. We could actually take insurance out on the business because it means if it gets trashed then we get money back, but you know, that's money that we don't really have. I'm trying to find out where my estimated expenditure at the end of the month is. Because I haven't paid anything for any property yet, that's not updated property. M. Quirinali, I might have to give them a ring and just to see how much, because I cannot remember how much the rent was. So M. Quirin, who? Right, doesn't seem to be anyone by that name. Oh shit! No. No, that's advertisement. Oh, that's because that's the area that it's in. It's not who I've loaned it off. Well, renting it from. I'm estimated to make a loss. Well, I made a loss yesterday. Right, so the rent is $3,500, which I've got. The staff, I've got enough for staff and rent, which is the two main expenditure. So these are still quite busy and I'm still quite empty, so I need to do something about this dire situation. So we've got some flyers out. Posters are quite expensive. I'm not going to go down that route just yet. However, I am going to check the stocks to make sure that I've got ample stock. Good job I checked, because there's no meat. Get them from these. Get 3 days worth of meat. There's no point spending too much on meat because not many pizzas require it. So lemon balm, it's £5 from there, it's £9 from there, it's £8 from there, £8 from there. Yeah, I think £5's probably going to be the best I get, unless any of these are feeling like, nope, that's 10, 17, yeah, no thanks. Oh shit, the restaurants are closing. Right, quick, lemon balm. Get some. And apples. Just quickly buy some of these so I've got some stock for the morning. There. Right, so I've got all that, there. Right, I'm fully stocked. So I can end the day. So 76 pizzas, which is an improvement over the 69 yesterday, even though I met none of the demand. So yeah, I made a profit, which is always handy. I'm not sure what I was looking for there. I was looking at, I don't know. That's only £100 profit, really. Not even. But the end of the month is nigh in a few days' time. Have a quick look in here. Yo, what do you think of the place? Could get used to the room if you had to. Ah, if you are blind. And yet they are still, you know, living the dream. So I may go get some joke articles. Yes, I wish to buy some joke articles. Stink bomb. Ooh, it's expensive. But it'll be worth it for the increased footfall. I'm hoping that that's not going to push us. Oh, shit. That's why you don't keep on clicking. Because you accidentally skip the day. Right, you, have a fucking stink bomb. So, you can see straight away, he's lost some people. Well, they've all come back now. Oop, and he's empty. So, I've got a few people in. But again, it's not many. Right, where'd I go wrong with the stocks? Cheese. Can't get far without cheese in the pizza business. Unless you're making some sort of weird cheeseless pizza. Actually, I've got to buy a lot of Parmesan, so I'm going to shop around for a better deal on that. For things where it's just, you know, one of them per day is alright, but Parmesan's 460, mozzarella's 413 from here. So 460, 413, that's more expensive. 413, that's the same. Parmesan's a lot more expensive though. What about you? Mozzarella's a lot cheaper, so I'm going to get you. Well, it's not a lot cheaper, it's only about like 20 pence cheaper, but yeah. I don't want to buy too much because you run the risk of it going off or someone accidentally throwing it all out, which does happen, and it's a lot more common than you may think. Yeah, that other one's going to, this is going to be the best option because I don't really want to go one star, because when you've got competitors nearby, the quality of your pizza does actually matter. If I get 50 Parmesan. So, what about the rest? I've got no strawberries, but strawberries, you know, who wants strawberry on a pizza? Ah, see, surprise, the strawberries were rotten. Don't let it happen again. Stay late, you fucking better. I'll be watching you like a hawk. See, so that's the edge that I've got in this area. I may have a shit restaurant with shit quality ingredients and a shit chef, but I'm cheap. To be fair, that does get a lot of places quite far. Just not us. let's have a look, see if there's been any change in the trend. Mandarin oranges are in. Let's have a look, see how me trendy pizza's faring. Trend's 56. But it's got no mandarin orange on. To be fair, I'm not really that arsed about putting any mandarin orange on, because at the end of the day, it means that I've got to buy mandarin orange. It's not like a stock oh no, I do. Yes, I do. Actually, yeah. Fuck it. I'm going to put mandarin orange on. It's a shame that you can't just modify the recipe. You've got to recreate it. So, wait. What's in? Pork, radishes, pineapple, mandarin orange. I'm just going to put the top four on, you know, shrimps and cockles. You have to buy the ingredient. And it's just a waste of money, really. So pork, radishes, pineapple, mandarin oranges. What was it again? I forgot already. Pork, radish, pineapple, orange. Pork, radish, pineapple, orange. Come on. That's easy to remember. Come on. Oh, shit. Pork, radish, pineapple, orange. Shit. Bake. Yes. Right. Let's stick some tomatoes on. I'm not asked about putting too many on, but tomatoes make a base for every pizza, and I'm trying to keep the normality, you know, down. Well, up. Stick some pork on. What else was next? It was radish. Yes. You decorate you like that. And then what was it? Pork, radish. I know orange was on, but what was the other one? Pineapple, that was it. No, that's a kiwi. That's decidedly not pineapple-esque. So you strew them about the pizza like that and stick some of that shit on there. And then orange. So you go like that. And then stick a bit of cheese on top. Go for the mozzarella because I've got the good quality mozzarella in at the moment. So may as well make hay while the sun shines, really. If you've got it, flaunt it. Oregano, well, that's what I was looking for. And dot, 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 dot. Right, let's see what these fools think. 4, 8. 0, 4, 4. Trendy shit. There, right. Stick that on the. Oop, it's already on the menu. How much does it cost to make? That's not too bad. You know, that's quite a nice margin. Where's all me fucking customers went? Animated stats. Where have you all gone? Well, that's a capacity. Pizza, no reputation. Here we go. Alright, so the menu is good. Advertising, good. Awards, good. Price, I'm assuming. Question mark. That's what happens when you get sabotaged by the customers. The customers. Yeah, because the customers sabotage the place. They come in with stink bombs of rats in the pockets. Well, you never know, maybe she does. There's a bit of a mismatch between the avatar and the character. That looks very. It looks like he's wearing one of the stools on his head. Is that where that stool's went? Yeah, she's got a rat as well. Everyone hates the furnishings. But I don't care. Oh, there's the waiter. Right. So, just double check. I know that I've checked, but, you know, shit happens and stuff gets thrown away. So I've got the capacity. Go. Right. So, 78. So I made 450 profit. Right, double check the capacity. See where the bottleneck is. There isn't one. But the capacity, the demand looks a lot lower than it did. So, so you're trendy shit. Trend's 104, which means it's mega trendy. Don't let it happen again. Whatever. Get lost, old man. I'm not that old. Well, she's a fan. You know, someone's got to love the shit that I produce. Just like the viewers. So the stink bomb seems to have impacted their restaurant, just not as much as I would have liked. Stick some more flyers out. So yeah, let's end the day. Aren't enough supplies. I fucking checked. I checked. Fuck off. Well, I'm selling trendy shit, so that's good. To be honest, I wonder if I could maybe bump it up a bit. It's on there for 10. I wonder if I could maybe stick it up to 12 or something. Because it's trendy, and trendy means popular, and popular means sales. So I'm going to try 13, actually. I'm not going to tamper with them because they're the fucking mainstay. The customers don't quite like the menu for some reason. Maybe that's where I'm going wrong. The menus are just too shit. I know. Let's try creating some other shit. Right. Tomatoes. Stick some tomatoes on. I'll try creating a pizza that I would eat and see how well that goes. So I'm quite a bit of a spice fanatic. I like hot things, so let's stick some chilies on. And some chopped chilies. And let's see what else. Let's stick some salami on. Because everyone loves salami. Yeah, I want to do it in a bit better pattern than that. And I've just had a notification there that my computer is going to get restarted by my antivirus. So hopefully it doesn't do that now. Because that would be really, really inappropriate. Come on, let's get it properly. No, that looks shit. There, that looks better. Right. So, let's get some mince. Let's stick some mince on because, you know, the more meat, the merrier. Right, what else should I put on? Onion. Let's stick some onion on. No, I didn't want the little ones. But that's an onion ring. And, whatever. I'm following this pattern of putting six. For some reason, six seems to be the popular. That looks shit. There. And then stick a little bit of onion in the middle. Actually, no, that's not. Right, so next up is peppers. Let's stick some peppers in. Stick a big pepper in the middle. And then you go like that. What else should I put on? What is nice? Let's stick some. I'm surprised that they don't have garlic. You know, garlic's quite a big favourite for pizzas. Let's stick some oregano leaves on. And then some ground oregano. Like so. And then some mozzarella. Let's stick a hunk of it there. Like that. A hunk of burning love. Although it's mozzarella, so it's not exactly love. I'm not sure where I was quite going with the Elvis reference. Right. Voila. He likes it. That must be me. Catchy name. It's a pizza that I would have, so I don't know, let's call it flux off. Because it sounds like fuck off. That's the joke. Stick it on for 10. I need it. Well, actually, it's going to be quite expensive. No, actually, no. And it's got pretty good ratings, actually. You know, high fives all round for flux off. Him again. Don't let it happen, you fucking freeloader. So, I'm eating ham pizza. It's stale. Right. So, how are they doing? They're still booming. In fact, they're probably more booming now than they were before. So, let's end the. Oh, shit, I forgot to check the supplies, didn't I? Fuck. At least there was no expenditure, so it was all profit today. Right, supplies. You're quite cheap. Let's get you. I'm gonna shop around for the tomato price. Oh, what am I on about? There is garlic. Had a bit of a brain fart there. Right, so how much was tomatoes there? They were like £1 odd. £1.08. 1.18. 1.47. 67 pence. I'm fucking getting used. Let's get enough for. I'm not sure why my popularity is -6. That's bad. Local share 10%. Right, so I've got all of that. Let's get some beef. That's £10. That's the same one. That's £12. That's £9. Let's get some of the £9 beef. Egg, provolone, parsley, and oregano's quite expensive. I'm going to see if I can get it cheaper. Not from you. You don't do anything. How much was oregano from there? It was 13.5. So you don't sell it. You sell it for 24. Ah, 10. Let's get 3 days' worth. Right, and it's just came up that the supply of radishes has been thrown out, but I've got radishes, so what are you on about? Have I just bought radishes and not realised? Are you eating anything? No? Whatever. Park a double decker between his teeth. Right. Aren't enough supplies? I fucking just bought a load of supplies. How do I not have enough supplies? You know, this game beggars belief at times. I would love to know what I've run out of. Although, to be fair, I don't think it's meant to be played as, you know, skipping every day. I think you're meant to play it as in, like, you know, you wait. You actually do the full day. But I'm too impatient. I can't wait for the full day. I just get bored. Right, so that's looking healthy. Anything running low? I'm running low on pork. I'll get some more of these. So pork, salami. Get it. So I've got 3 days' worth of shit. I can't get squid, but whatever. I'll get squid from the fish place. Sorted. Right. I should probably check the rest of the stock. I've got 2 days' worth of parmesan. I think they found out this was the cheapest place, or the cheapest good-ish place. Supplies of chilies were rotten. I've bought chilies, so whatever. Quattro stagioni. No one's eaten flux off or trendy shit yet. Ah, the price is quite acceptable, is it? Well, guess what's going up in price? Maybe not so high. 12. Right, there we go. Managed to meet 100% of the sales, and the sales is actually climbing, which is always good. Right, here's the end of the month, so electricity is 360. Ooh, that's, you know, that's quite low. Oh shit, I'm in debt. Shit. By £8. I'm £8 in debt. I'm probably going to get a negative thing for it. Do you want to take part in the pizza competition? Hell fucking yes. After the. Do I want to stake any money on it? Well, I can't stake any more or less because I'm skint. So. Let's go for speed 3. Top pizza! Right, let's have a look at this shit. Broccoli! Please, no, it's this fucking. I hate this pizza. I hate it with a passion. Hate it. I can't remember if it's one of the ones that I did when I was challenging some people, but it's a shit pizza. The good thing about it is that it's just broccoli and cauliflower. But the fact that you've got to watch them put every single piece of broccoli down and every single piece of cauliflower down is just a fucking ball ache. So, at least we've got this groovy porn music in the background. I wonder if repairmen listen to this, and plumbers, and all the other sort of assorted porn troops. Boom, 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 boom. I feel like I should be wearing like a fake mustache or something while listening to this. So as you can see, it's a fucking field of broccoli and then the fucking smothering it with cauliflower. I wish I'd went for a faster speed now. But the thing is, you never know which pizza they're going to pick. They can pick any of the pizzas. And if it's one that I haven't done before, then I'd be fucked if I put on too high of a speed. But then when you get this one, you just go, you know, fuck you. It's... There should have really been an option to speed up or slow down. Well, to be fair, I suppose, you know, you've got to stick by your choice. If you go too fast, then you're fucked, basically. But then again, it would be good to have the flexibility to have that sort of choice. Right, so it's just broccoli and cauliflower. Get ready. Come on. Let's get this shit done. Get her done. Come on. Right. Okay. Go. Broccoli. Broccoli. Where? No. Broccoli. Shit. No. Shit. Broccoli. Go. Smother it in fucking broccoli. Smother it. I'm not even counting. I haven't even counted the fucking... Shit. Broccoli, ahoy! Come on, don't lag. Right, cauliflower. No, that's meat. Collie, where are you there? No, that's a mushroom. Right, time to draw this fucking arrow. Click, 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 click. Enough. Right, that's good enough. Go. 19. That's not bad. 20s, you know. That's the upside of that pizza is that it's easy to make, but it's fucking boring to watch. So I've got 132. Yes, I've done it again. What can I say? I am just the master. You're watching a true genius at work, yeah. What? 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 Oh, right, because... no, eh? Oh, man, I got me fucking hopes up there. What the fuck? Shit, I wish that... Fuck, man. So what happens to the rest of the money? Because if everyone puts in 500 quid, I've only just got 500 quid back. So, where's everyone else's 500 quid went? I should be getting their 500 quid. I don't know, that seems like a pyramid scheme to me. So anyway, I think that's going to be it. I'm really hitting her spot apparently. Probably because of the porn music. Boom, 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 boom. So yeah, I'm going to call this one, curtail it here. So hopefully I will see you in the next episode where hopefully we make more money. Until then, farewell.